Let's talk about overall market. Prashant, is GST emerging as a risk factor for the market in the near term? Because again, you're not looking at 1 week move, but the fact is that we've started to all of a sudden underperform the global markets while we were outperforming till now. Is GST emerging as a bit of an unknown which could derail the market, at least in the near term?
I don't think so. The market should worry about GST at all. In fact, GST is happening in the middle of a financial year. So if you look at the whole year, I don't think it will impact either the economy or the earnings at all. And if you think slightly longer term, GST will make tax evasion very difficult. It will improve tax compliance. So I think tax to GDP ratio in India should get a meaningful fillip. And that over time could actually lead to moderate levels of taxation. So I think lower fiscal deficit is very good for us in the longer term. It should improve significantly the ease of doing business when things stabilize. Of course, for a few weeks or few months, there could be some dislocation in few businesses, but I don't think the earnings over a year are going to get impacted. So I think, to my mind, it's a non-event as far as the equity markets are concerned.
Okay. Naren, your thoughts on that? Because, you know, over the last 1 week, the one word that I've heard all through is destocking. And, you know, I mean, it's not as if people are going to stop consuming, goods going forward. But there is that uncertainty factor, right? Someone told me, for example, tomorrow restaurants will close at 11 p.m. because they don't know at midnight how to transition into GST. So, I mean, is there going to be a near-term earnings hit? And is this, in that case, a buying opportunity?
I think, like Vetri mentioned, you can't, if you're looking at mutual fund, you're not investing for 1 week. So, go back 3 years back, I think we spent a lot of TV time trying to tell people, if GST comes, it's a massive re-rating. One day before the launch of GST, we are saying GST is a derating possibility. So I find it very interesting because for almost 6 months, many times the markets came down saying, no, GST may not happen.
Yeah.
And today, one day before GST, we are arguing the other way. I think luckily as mutual fund investors, we don't look with a 1 week view. Mm-hmm. And clearly, we are very positive on GST. I think nowhere in the world GST has been implemented without any hiccups. As a mutual fund investor, I will look beyond the hiccups and I will use any opportunity of hiccup to buy.
Are there any listed stocks where company where they employ a lot of CAs or, you know, they're doing GST filing? I'm sure you would have looked at them.
I think there is a lot of uncertainty that's there around this quarter and into the next quarter. While, you know, the long-term benefits, I think, are there to stay, but we might go through a couple of quarters of volatility in terms of what to expect from companies and what companies themselves will get to see from the markets. So I think that could be one of the big opportunities that investors could use to buy into the markets also.
Okay. Vetri, GST historically in countries where it's been introduced has been inflationary, and there's a good chance that it happens in India as well. Would you agree with that? Would you think that that's a bit of a risk over the next 3 or 4 quarters?
No, I think specifically on that, Anuj, while you're right that it has had that impact in many other countries, I think in India the GST Council has gone out of the way to sort of try and make sure that GST should not be inflationary, and therefore they've set rates based on this premise that they don't want to have an inflationary impact. And I think some of the other things that they're doing as well, whether you like it or not, in terms of the new authority which will monitor whether people are profiteering from GST, etc., are all sort of designed to sort of ensure that inflation doesn't become a big issue. So I think it's highly unlikely that you will see that as a problem.
What's the current AUM, mutual fund AUM, 18 lakh crores, Prashant? 19 lakh crores. Okay, 19 lakh crores. Over the next 4 or 5 years, do you see it doubling? Yes or no?
Equities, yes.
Equities, yes.
Yes.
Okay. Naren, what kind of growth rate can we expect in AUMs?
Yeah, I think doubling in 5 years is a simple prospect.
Doubling in 5 years would be very simple. Anup, you think we'll be able to, over the next 4 or 5 years, take back some of the equity ownership from FIIs back to domestic investors?
So let me give you a very convoluted but very different answer. So I believe if you think of an investor like a mother-in-law, if you look at real estate as the daughter, and equities is like the daughter-in-law. So the daughter is not in the house, so you know, now the mother-in-law likes the daughter-in-law, but when she comes back, the love is always kept for the daughter.
Vetri, your thoughts on how, you know, the equity cult, you know, because that's something that, you know, I want to basically talk about. Equity cult. I think personally, I really, you know, got excited by the kind of equity investments we have seen from Indian public at large. But, you know, if you compare them to, say, US, Canada or developed countries, I take the point about the per capita income, of course. But do you think there's, you know, way to go as far as this number is concerned on the upside?
No, I think it can certainly grow, and you know, even the doubling in 5 years, which is nominal terms 14%, is not impossible in an economy which in nominal terms is growing, you know, at 11-12%. So it's certainly possible. But I think the, you know, sort of missing piece in this is that if you look at the experience that you talked about, the US in particular, which we all use as the example, the growth of that industry happened simply because, in a way, the money got compulsorily directed into markets and through into equities through the whole IRA, 401ks, defined benefit plans, etc. And while it's great that we've got people to come in through the SIP route, it's still discretionary, right? The 401ks, the IRAs, actually, they're not discretionary. Once you're there, you're pretty much locked into it. So I think really what I would like to see over time is that whole retirement pipeline grow and retirement money coming into it, you know, whether it is tax deferred, tax protected, whatever. But I think if that happens, then we can be a lot more confident about how the growth will pan out for the Indian mutual fund industry and particularly the equity component of it.
Oh, yes. Krishna, that point is taken, right? I mean, also, you know, the fact is that no other asset class is making money right now. It's the financial services which is making money and financial assets, equities in particular. Do you think that that's going to be the driving factor from here on?
See, I have a lot more optimistic view on equities and equity mutual funds. I think we should be probably growing much faster at more than 25-30% CAGR for the next many years, given the kind of growth that we are expected to see in the economy and the income levels will go up and the inflation that's going to be well contained. I think the you know, savings rate will continue to inch up and a lot more will come into equities, given that the expectations on returns are moderated to 10-12% tax-free, and I think equity funds continue to deliver that. I think on a longer term, I think the growth rate could be much faster.
Okay, thank you so much, audience, and thank you to the panel for taking time out and answering all the questions. Thanks a lot. A big round of applause for the panel, please.